Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you IP address, MAC address and port address of node in computer network. We have seen OSI model in my previous video. In that, I have explained you how exactly port address is added in transport layer, how exactly MAC address that has been added in data link layer, and I have shown you how exactly IP address that we are adding in network layer. In this video, I'll explain you each and every basics regarding all these addresses. And here, I'll show you some practical examples of my computer even that will give you more clarity regarding how exactly all these addressings are happening with any computer inside computer network. So let me show you first how exactly all these addresses are added in OSI layer. So here, let me show you first how OSI layers are there. So there are total 7 layers in OSI model. And I have told you, this first 3 layers that will be giving you data, right? This data may be text, it may be audio, it may be video, and size of this data may be large, right? So when you want to transmit data on computer network, first of all, we will be bisecting this data into segments, and that segmentation that is happening at transport layer, right? When it comes to segmentation, along with segments, we are adding few additional information. Like, let me show you how things are happening. Let us say we are having large file of data over here. First, we are bisecting that into segments. Here, I'm bisecting that as per S1, S2, up to SN. So here, when you provide segmentation at transport layer, we are bisecting data into small, small chunks. And with those segments, we will be providing two things. One is sequence number and second is port number. So this port number, that will be port address. And this port address that will be belonging to process. I'll explain you later like how exactly it belongs to process. But right now you just consider the data which is given by this 3 layer that is getting bisected into segments first. And with each segment, there will be sequence number and port number. And this port number that will be port address, right? Once you are having segment, that segment will be given to network layer. And network layer will be forming packets from the segments. Now, what is the meaning of packet? See, along with segments, network layer will add IP address of source and destination. So segments plus IP address of source and destination, that will be giving you packet. And once you are having packet, that packet will be given to data link layer, and data link layer will form frames over here. So what is frame? Frame will be packet plus MAC address of source and destination, and along with that it will add some tail bits, right? So you see, at data link layer we are adding MAC address, at network layer we are adding IP address, and at transport layer we are adding port number, or you can say port address. So if you observe the complete format of frame, so inside frame there will be MAC address, that will be physical address of device, there will be IP address, that will be logical address of device, there will be port address that is there inside segment, right? And that port address that belongs to process. So here, up to this, what you can understand is, inside your computer, you may be running multiple processes. Like in your computer, you may be opening YouTube, you may have opened up with Engineering Funda web page, as well as there can be many other internet applications that may be running right now inside your computer. So all those applications are having individual separate processes. So with each process, there will be port number inside your computer, right? Now, to forward data inside network, we need to have logical addressing that is been provided by IP address. And to have services, we will be giving physical address of source and destination that will be given by MAC address, right? Now, let me show you some basic fundamentals which are there regarding IP, MAC and port address. After that, I'll give you one practical example, as well as I'll show you my computer's data in terms of IP, MAC and port address, right? So here, first of all, let me explain you how port address is there. So see, in computer, data should be given to write process assigned by the port number. Like you see, as I have told you, inside your computer, there may be many processes which is happening right now, right? So with each process, there will be well-defined port number, right? So port address is the address of process in given computer or node, right? Every process in computer has unique port number. Port number is assigned at transport layer with a given segment. I have told you, after three layer, you will be having a data. Let me show you. See, after three layer, you will be having a data. That data is bisected into segments. So with each segment, there will be well-defined port number, right? So here, port number is assigned at transport layer with a given segment. Port is also referred as communication endpoint. And you will be observing there can be fixed or dynamic ports and range of port number that varies from 0 to 65535. This is very essential. You should know port number range that is there from 0 to 65535. So port address is what? Port address is an address of process inside your computer. And range of port address is there from 0 to 65535. Right. Now, let us see how IP address is there. IP means internet protocol. Every node inside computer network is identified with IP address only. There can be two types of IP address like IPv4 and IPv6. Usually, you will be observing we are using IPv4 address in TCP/IP protocol. So, I'll be discussing about IPv4 only right now over here in this video. Later when I explain you IP addressing with detailed videos, at that time I'll show you how exactly IPv4 and IPv6 addresses are there. Right now consider IPv4, that is the address which is there with my computer, and that will be giving you logical addressing. IP address is added with segment to form packets at network layer. So initially I have told you, you see, at network layer what we do, we take segment as input over here. And by adding source and destination IP with segment, we form packet. So IP addresses are added at network layer, right? Now, here you should know, my dear students, IP address can be based on location of device and it can change manually. So here, there are a few basic things that you should know. See, there will be IP address of network. Like for example, right now I'm having one LAN. So that LAN will be having one IP address. Now, as if I add one computer inside my LAN, then that IP address of that computer, that will be as per my network only. Like if my computer is shifted in other's LAN, then its IP address will change, right? So IP address that is there based on in which location computer is there, as well as we can change IP address manually, right? You will be observing range of IPv4 address that is having size of 32 bits and it is having range from 0.0.0.0 to 255.255.255.255. So that is the range of IPv4 address, right? So here there are few basic things that you should note down. Like IP address is a logical address. It is having size of 32 bits. Its range is there from 0.0.0.0 to 255.255.255. That forms logical addressing. And when you add any computer inside given LAN at that time, as per that network, IP address will be given to that computer. And you can even manually change IP address of any computer, right? So IP addressing is a logical addressing. At routing level, we are having IP addressing, right? Now, next is MAC address. So let us see how MAC address is there. MAC is media access control. Every node in LAN is identified with the help of MAC address only. See, MAC address is a physical address. So inside LAN, physical addressing of that computer that will happen with respect to MAC address only, right? See, here you can say this MAC address is a physical address of device. If I say IP gives location of node, then you can say MAC is giving you name of the node in given LAN. Like see, for example, if I say one LAN that is there somewhere inside Surat and inside that LAN, if I say location is Surat, then inside that LAN, whatever computers are there, that will be assigned with name, that name will be MAC address, right? So IP explains you the location of node, and MAC explains you the physical address of that given node, that you can say. So MAC is a unique address. MAC cannot be changed. Once manufacturer is fabricating any computer, along with that well-defined MAC address will be there. MAC address cannot be changed. It will be fixed, right? It will be unique address, while IP address will changes with respect to location, as well as manual change is also possible, right? So here you can say MAC address, that gives you physical address, and you will be observing MAC is 12 digits hex code, and 12 digit hex code means what? It is having size of 48 bits, right? One digit is having size of 4 bits. So 12 digit hex code, that is having size of 48 bits. MAC is a unique code for any given node, and that is assigned by manufacturer of computer or router, that you can see. Let me give you one example. My computer is having MAC address with Wi-Fi of 18:47:3D:D7:C8:73. So this is MAC address of Wi-Fi which is there with my computer. Now there are few more basics that you should know. Like, see, my computer, that is having Wi-Fi connectivity, as well as it is having LAN connectivity. In LAN connectivity, there is a physical addressing which is happening as per NIC. So network interface card, that is also having another MAC address with my computer. This is Wi-Fi's MAC address. Likewise, I can have Ethernet LAN connection with NIC network interface card, that is also having another physical address, right? As well as one more physical connection is there as per optical cable connection. So with my computer, there are three MAC address. One is for Wi-Fi, second is for Ethernet, and third is for optical cable connection, right? And those are unique number. So that says exact address of that given node, right? And here you will be observing with some MAC address, there can be separators as per dash or dot or colon, right? So with my computer with Wi-Fi, separator is colon, but this dash or dot, that may be there, and this will be defined by manufacturer, right? See, MAC address, that will be added with packet to form frames at data link layer. So I have already explained all those things in OSI model. See what happens when you have packets at the output of network layer. You see, network layer will be giving you packets at output. So that packets will be given to data link layer, and it will form frames, right? So here what we are doing is, by adding MAC address with packets, we form frame. Now let me give you one practical example of this entire addressing that will give you more clarity regarding how exactly all these addresses are there, right? Like, if you observe here, I'm having one computer, that is my computer. Inside my computer, I'm running three processes. One is YouTube. I have opened up with Flipkart website, as well as I have opened Engineering Funda website. So with these three processes, there will be well-defined port number. With these three processes, there will be well-defined port number, or you can say port address, right? And this port address, that will be given by transport layer, right? This port address, that will be given by transport layer. And that range of port address, that is there from 0 to 65535. And my computer is there inside one local area network. And that IP of my computer with Wi-Fi, that is as per 192.168.0.126. So this is IP of this computer, and 126, that is noted over here by red color. Why? The reason is, it could change with respect to any computer over here. Like if I say this computer that is there inside this LAN, then it may be having any other number over here instead of 126, right? So that gives you logical addressing. For example, if I add another computer over here, then with respect to this LAN only, address will be given to next computer. right? So that is how logical addressing is there in IP. It is having size of 32 bits, right? And it is having range from 0.0.0 to 255.255.255 with IPv4 addressing, right? It gives you logical addressing, and that is happening at network layer. Remember this, where segments will be given to network layer, and it will add IP address of source and destination to form packet, right? Now, once you have packets, it will be given to data link layer, and data link layer will gives you frames over here. Now, that data link layer will add physical address. So physical address will be there as per Wi-Fi or Ethernet cable, whatever port is there, that port will be having physical address, that will be MAC address, right? So here you will be observing switches are performing that switching of data with respect to MAC address, but router is performing that switching of data with respect to IP address, right? Why? The reason is, with router you will be observing it is layer 3 device. You see, let me show you. See, router, that is layer 3 device. So in layer 3 device, network layer will come into the picture where IP addressing is happening, but switches are layer 2 device in which data link layer will be there, which forms frame as per MAC address, right? Now what I'll do is, I'll show you one practical example of my computer, in which how port number is there, how IP address is there, as well as how MAC address is there. Everything that I'm going to show you over here. If you observe here, some packets that I have received. Now out of this, let me consider one packet over here, that is this TCP packet, and see destination address, that is this, and source address, that is my computer's address, right? So these are IP address, right? This is destination IP address, and this is source IP address. Now as if I click on this, here few information will come. Now in this information, you see this Ethernet information that is there. So if I open this Ethernet information, then you see what is happening here. Here I'm having MAC address, right? See, this is MAC address of my computer with Wi-Fi, right? See, this is 12 digit hex code that you can say, right? And this is MAC address of my router, which is of TP-Link. You see, that is having this MAC address, right? So this is how MAC address is there, and this is how IP address is there with this particular frame. And inside this frame, as if you want to see how port number is there, here with TCP protocol, you see source port, that is Z60280, that is a source port, and destination port is 443. So that is how port address is there, right? So port address range, that is there from 0 to 65535, right? That is there based on process. While MAC address, that is a physical address, right? So TP-Link and my computer is having this physical address, and IP address, that is there at network layer, which is there for logical addressing. So this is how things are there. So I hope now it is clear to you, like how IP, MAC and port addresses are there. Still, if anything that you would like to share it with me, note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.